Yeah, we've been able to get away with no severe thunderstorm warnings, some lightning, but fortunately a lot of heavy rain over where those lightning strikes are. So hopefully we don't have any new fires to tell you about come evening tonight. There is a look at the heavy storms moving out of Melbourne now on our storm tracker radar, headed over toward Valkyria. Malabar around 5:30, 5:45, Indian Harbor Beach as well by about 5:25. Gusty winds, heavy rain and lightning on the way. Let me show you the Viper radar, because we are continuing to track additional showers along the Brevard and Volusia coast. As you head a little farther to the north, there's Cape Canaveral getting hit with that line of heavy storms. It's all from our sea breezes that collided, and now they're all moving eastward at around 10 to 15 miles an hour. Heavy storms moving out of Titusville now. Rain wrapping up over East Seminole, but I'm still watching this particular storm just back building, moving back to the west here across I-4, spreading some clouds and light rain over toward Port Orange. That heavy cell not moving a whole lot right now. A couple of spotty showers still left along the Lake Orange line, and a few down here southwest of Kissimmee may hold together and bring you another round of a little bit of light rain here over the next hour before everything tries to wrap up. Let me show you some of the rain totals here. Flagler Beach, the highest one I could find. 2/3 of an inch of rain. Kissimmee, Apopka, 1/2 inch. Port Orange, 1/3 of an inch. Bellevue, 1/4. DeLand, Claremont, about 1/10. And a whole new chance coming up tomorrow. Happy to report Daytona Beach got 1/2 an inch. Last time we had a good soaking of more than 1/4 inch was March 11th in Orlando and Melbourne. I'll have the Melbourne rain totals coming up, but we only got about 0.07 at Orlando today. All right, right now rain cools 71 at OYA. We're back up to 80 in Sanford, 84 right now in Ocala, and 70s along the coast. Hour by hour, just a spotty shower left over through about 8 o'clock tonight in Orlando. We'll wake up in the mid-60s, and then scattered storms building back in through the day tomorrow at about 50%, so the hit or miss stuff. Saturday, though, this storm system really diving through the Gulf, going pretty far south for this time of the year. Very unusual. Yesterday, it looked like our severe weather threat might be a little more of a concern. Today, our models are backing off on that just a bit, but it's something we have to monitor very closely on into the upcoming weekend. But guess what? A lot more rain to come. We're talking inches of rain in spots before the weekend is over. Next week looks very nice. I'll be talking more about it at 5, guys. Back to